Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at what are the new things that are added to version 9.2.0. There are 7 new things that are added, so let's see them one by one. The first thing that has been added is this keyBy method on the ARR helper class. So let's see that. Here I have this ARR and I have copied the same example from the pull request. We have this data in an array. And we want to key them by this ID, which means that we want to add a key as this ID. Then we can just use ARR and key by. And you can see here the keys are added like this. And you can see here the ID is same in this and this, but the last one will take the priority if we have the same ID twice. So you need to keep that in mind as well. The second thing that has been added is this attributes width. But it is now changed to make instead of with. There was this new thing added to the Laravel version at the end of the version 8. And it's also added in the documentation of the Laravel and the what's new in Laravel 9 as well, because it was released very late. And we could just do it like this, the new attribute syntax. But now we can also just write here with static method. And the method name is changed to make instead of with. And there are so many other objects that have this with static method in order to instantiate the object of that class. So this also has been added to this attribute class. And sorry, it is not with method, but it is a make method. Because if you look here, the method is make. That make method is in many other classes like collection. The third thing that has been added is this expects output to contain a certain string whenever we are testing a command. I have this test command over here. If you look here, I have this test command over here and I am just outputting this hello world over here. And here in the test command test, I have just this artisan test command and I am expecting the output to be hello world. And now I'll say PHP artisan test filter and test command output test, which is the name of this method. Okay, so I'll just hit run over here, then it passes. And now if I change this to some, let's say, random string over here and save, and again run the same test, then it will fail because it is expecting a different output. The fourth thing is integrate Laravel CORS into the framework. Before, whenever we install Laravel, it used to install this Laravel CORS package into the framework. So it would be just by default available to us. But now this has been integrated to the core. And if you want to just remove the dependency, if you have previously installed via Composer, then you can just go to this pull request and just see here. You can change this to this in this app.http.kernel.php file. And you can just remove this fruitcake Laravel CORS and upgrade the Laravel version to 9.2. The fifth thing that has been added is this betweenFirst to Stringable. Let me just show you that. So before, if we had this string and we wanted anything that is between this opening square bracket and closing square bracket, then if I run it, then we'll get this. We'll get from first to last. It will check anything that is between the first square bracket and the last closing square bracket. But let's say we only want one, which is between this first two square brackets. Then we can do this by using this new method between first. And you can see here I am only getting one, which is between this first two square brackets. The sixth thing that has been added is this headers. So whenever we are using this mail always to for a certain email, and if you don't know about this, then we can just use it in a development environment or a local environment. And whenever we send a mail to someone, it will always be sent to this email. So it is very handy for the testing environment or the local environment. So whenever we use this, then we used to lose the CC and BCC whenever we were sending the email, whenever we were testing. So we would not know whether the CC or BCC was being applied actually. So now whenever we are using this always to, and then we are using CC and BCC in a mail facade, then in the headers of the email, we'll be able to see this X2CC and XBC headers. This is very handy to know whether the CC and BCC were actually been applied or not. And it will not actually send email to these emails. It will only send the email to this to email. It is just to make us know that these will be sent whenever we remove this always to. The final thing that has been added is this allowing specifying custom message for the rules object. Previously, there was no way of adding custom message to the new rule object using the validate method. We could do that by creating a messages method. Let me show you that here, the test rule. We could do that by using this message method, and we can just send whatever the message that we want whenever something goes wrong in a validation rule. But now we have the ability to define that in the validate method on the controller itself. And here in my Laratips website, I have this form. Let me just go to this welcome.blade, and here I have this hidden input as a test and the value is random. But in the rule, I have checked that the value must be yes, otherwise this message will be shown as a validation message, and the message will be shown over here, and it is being used over here. So let me just write that this validate and test required new test rule. So now here, if I just fill the form and hit save, then you can see here the value must be yes, which is coming from this test rule. But now there is an extra way of writing this validation message. If you want to override that message, then you can just write here like this: test rule class and your message. And let me come here and again fill the form and save it. Then we can see the value must be test from the validate method, which is coming from this, and it is overriding this message. So this can be very useful if you want to override the messages from a package.